my way over to the store to do a little bit of shopping, so I thought maybe you'd like to come
Olivia!
Go with me. You know, I love to shop.
Olivia, come quickly. I have it. I have it.
Maestro Flamingo, well, what is it that you have?
I have my new opera.
Your new opera? Well, what is it?
An opera is a story that is sung. You sing everything you say in an opera, and sometimes you even sing a song. You sing a song, you sing a song, you sing a song, you sing a song, and sometimes you even sing a song.
Well, I know what an opera is, but what is this opera? I mean, where did you get it? What's it about?
Oh, I wrote it myself, and it is about Sesame Street. It is called La Via Sesamia. It is the story of a flamingo and a woman who go around visiting all their friends on Sesame Street. I, the great Placido Flamingo, will play the flamingo, of course.
But of course.
And you, Olivia, most luckiest of peoples, will play the woman.
Well, I don't know.
You cannot say no. You have the most important part in the whole opera. Except for mine, of course.
Of course.
What's more, I have written a wonderful solo for you to sing.
Solo? I mean, really? Me a solo? I mean, well, what is it?
A solo is a song that you sing all alone. I know that you will like it if you try it. You stand right up and you sing by yourself, and everyone else keeps quiet.
Well, I know what a solo is.
Then let me tell you about this one. Imagine it. We will see you standing at the top of the stairs, dressed in a beautiful costume. You will come down the steps, the music will start, and you will sing a beautiful song, and everyone will listen.
Oh, it sounds wonderful. You know, I've always wanted to sing an opera. I really have. I mean, it's been like my dream, and
you will do it?
Yes, I will do it.
You promise?
I promise.
Good, then come along. We must hurry. The opera is going to start in a few minutes.
A few minutes? What are you talking? I haven't even seen the music. I don't even know what to sing.
Oh, do not worry. I will tell you what to sing. Trust me, Olivia. You will be magnificent.
Am I going to be sorry I said I would do this?
Come along, Olivia.
All right. Coming, maestro.
Z, 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 Z.
Get to the other side. I get it. To get to the other side. That's a good one.
Oh, Bert. Hey, Bert. I brought home a surprise, Bert.
That's nice, Ernie.
And Bert, you're going to guess what it is.
Oh, Ernie. Just tell me, okay?
But, Bert, if I told you what it is, it wouldn't be a surprise, would it? Besides that, this is going to be a lot of fun. You ready, Bert?
Huh?
I say, are you ready, Bert?
Okay, Ernie.
Okay, I'll give you a clue, okay? Your first clue is that it's little, Bert.
Little?
Mm-hmm.
Ernie, what kind of clue is that? That could be anything.
Well, it couldn't be Big Bird.
No, it couldn't be.
But I'll give you another clue. It's little and it's cute, Bert.
Ernie.
And it has four legs.
Wait, little, cute, and has four legs. I know. Two pigeons.
Bert, you're not trying.
Well.
No. Well, listen. This cute little four-legged creature has a waggly tail and a cold nose.
A waggly tail and a cold nose.
And it rhymes with guppy.
With gup.
And it sounds like that.
It's a puppy! Oh, Ernie!
You're right, Bert.
Oh, look at him.
Isn't he cute?
Oh, he's so terrific.
Yeah, what do you think we should name him, Bert?
Norman.
Norman.
Yeah.
How about something like Godzilla the Wonder Dog?
How about Norman?
How about we name him Bert?
Hmm? How about Alan?
Alan?
Yeah. How about Jim?
Un triangolo. Oh, es un techo. Un triángulo. Un pedazo de pastel. Un triángulo. Parece una vela. Busca un triángulo. Triángulo.
Who says five friends can't have fun? Who says five's not as good as one? Who says two is company, five's a mob? Gotta tell you, someone who says five's too much should get a job playing basketball. Who says five's not a real great time? We think five is quite sublime. See us walk and hear us talk. We most emphatically gotta squawk about being and feeling alive and five.
Is proud to present La Via Sesamia, an opera written by Placido Flamingo, directed by Placido Flamingo, and starring the great Placido Flamingo, also starring Olivia. In our first act, Placido Flamingo visits the fix-it shop. Let's watch.
Did you say something?
No.
That's funny. I thought I heard somebody talking.
Bang, bang, whir, whir. Wish-a-wish-a-wish-a-wish-a-wish. This is the music of the fix-it shop, where they'll mend a broken toy or dish. First we hear Maria as she hammers the nail and makes a lovely banging noise. Then we hear Luis whir away on the drill as he fixes one of Elmo's toys. Now they play together on the sandpaper, and the wish-a-wish-a-wish is everywhere. What a lovely feeling to be here in this place when the fix-it sounds are in the air. Bang, bang, whir, whir, wish-a-wish-a-wish-a-wish. This is the music of the fix-it shop, where they'll mend a broken toy or dish. Or a toy, or a dish, or a toy, or a dish, or a toy, or a dish. Ha 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 ha.
I have come here today because my toaster is broken and I want you to fix it for me. Where is my toaster? Bring in my toaster.
Here is your toaster. I brought you your toaster.
Put it on the counter. And when will my toaster be fixed?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow my toaster will be fixed. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow your toaster will be fixed. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow my toaster.
Your toaster tomorrow.
The toaster will be fixed. Tomorrow, 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 tomorrow. Thank you. Thank you.
Well, he told me he had a good part.
Ah, sing, Olivia. Remember, you are in an opera.
He told me he had a very good part for me in his opera. That's the only reason why I'm doing this. I feel silly, I feel foolish, but I promised, and now I have to go.
You know, living here can sometimes be very strange.
Yeah, I've noticed.
Wake up, Hortense. Time to rise and shine.
Where are they?
Where are what?
Five brooms. Where are the five brooms? They were all dressed up, and they waltzed across my room. One, two, three, four, five. Five brooms.
What did you say they did?
Five brooms danced around my room by the light of the moon. Five brooms.
I thought it looked a bit neat in here.
And now a Sesame Street news flash. We understand that some unfortunate piggies have just been left homeless. We take you now live to our reporter on the scene, Kermit the Frog.
Hi-ho, this is Kermit the Frog, and... Hi-ho, this is Kermit the Frog, and I am standing here beside the homes, or should I say the former homes, of the three little pigs. And, look, here comes one of these pigs right now. Excuse me, pig. Pardon me, pig. Kermit the Frog here of Sesame Street News. I was wondering, I see that your house, which was made of straw, was virtually doesn't exist anymore. Can you tell our audience how you feel about that, please?
Can I tell you how I feel about that?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, what kind of dumb question is that? I'm angry. That's how I feel about that. How would you feel if some big whoop came along and huffed and puffed and blew your house down, huh? Angry. That's how you feel?
Yes,
oh,
okay,
you newscasters.
Angry. Yes, well, that's one angry pig as well he might be. And looking a little further here, I think here comes another pig. Pardon me, pig. Pig, I see that your house, which was made of sticks, was virtually demolished. Can you tell our viewers how you feel about that, please?
How do I feel? How can you be so cruel as to ask me that? My house is in rubble here, and you ask me how I feel? Sad, that's how I feel. Oh, you news persons. How would you feel if some big wolf came by and blew and huffed and puffed on your lily pad, huh? How would you feel?
Well, I guess I would feel sad too.
Right.
Yes, sad it is.
Sad.
There goes one sad pig, but there seems to be another house left standing here, and this house here, which is made of bricks, and there is one of the pigs left out there.
Muffin, tell them to put the satellite dish on
the
other side of the squash
court. This is the owner of the brick house, which seems to be just fine. Pardon me, pig, I was wondering if you could tell our audience how you feel about your house sitting here nice and solid and strong.
Oh, well, how do I feel?
Mm-hmm.
Why, I feel... proud.
Proud?
Well, yes, proud. It took a long time to build this house. It is the strongest house on the block. And the old wolf couldn't blow this down if he tried to. Yes, I'd say I feel very, very proud.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Terrible. Oh, well, fellas, what seems to be the problem?
Oh, my house got blown in.
Mine, too.
Oh, gee, my house is still standing just fine. Whoa. Say, why don't you fellas join me and Muffin for a little while?
Really?
Yes, she just made some lemonade. We could have a couple of drinky-poos by the pool.
Hey, that makes me happy.
Oh. That makes me happy, too.
Don't fall into the conversation pit.
It looks like everybody ended up feeling nice and happy. So this has been Kermit the Frog reporting to you on the emotional state of the three little pigs, two of whom were left temporarily homeless as a result of some serious huffing and puffing from an alleged large wolf.
What do you mean, alleged?
This is Kermit the Frog signing off!
Once upon a time, there was a five that was more than just a five. It was Jive Five. One, two, three, four, five.
All right.
One, two, three, four, five frogs.
All right.
One, two, three, four, five. Five babies.
Be sure to stay tuned to WCTW today for
School in the Afternoon.
Yes, for the best in TV afternoon drama, stay tuned for The Edge of School, where today Katie will say to Phil,
"Gee, Phil, this is our first day of school here in the classroom. But what are all these other people doing here?"
I think, Katie, that when you go to school, one of the things about school is that you meet new people.
Then, later this afternoon, be sure to stay tuned for Another School, where today, Bruno says to Felicity,
"Felicity, here we are on our first day of school. What's that grown-up person doing there in the front of the room?"
"One plus one equals two."
"That's the teacher, Bruno. He helps us learn stuff here at school."
"Oh!"
Then be sure to stay tuned for All My School Children, where today Dick will say to Vanessa,
"Oh, teacher, I know the answer. Teacher, Vanessa.
Yoo-hoo, Vanessa."
"Yes, Dick."
"You're supposed to raise your hand when you want to answer. Oh. Didn't you know that?"
"No, I didn't, Dick, but I will from now on, thanks to you."
And then, finally, be sure to stay tuned for Love of School, where today Dwayne will say to Martha,
"Martha."
"Yes, Dwayne."
"I love school, Martha."
"Dwayne."
"Yes, Martha?"
"I love school, too."
So stay tuned all afternoon to WCTW, where it's always
school in the afternoon.
"Come on over for chorus rehearsal, Charlie.
Sure thing, Fred.
Wait for me, guys.
Spunky little fellow.
I'll make it now, guys.
Hold a rehearsal. I'm coming too.
I gotta get across, but I can't jump that far. What can I do? Not that way. That's it.
If you hang around playing with pebbles, Sonny, you'll never make it to the chorus.
I'll be there. Here I come.
Hello there, little frog. Glad you could make it. Say, the little guy's got a great tenor voice.
In the second act of our opera, La Via Sesamia, Placido Flamingo visits Big Bird, who is sad because his friend Mr. Snuffleupagus has gone to see his grandmother. Let's watch.
This is a sad bird. He's not a bad bird. He cries all the day for his friend who went away. No one can cheer him, and one who's near him gets tears in the eye and must break down and cry.
Gosh, you know, I'm a little sad, but I'm not that sad.
Big Bird, this is an opera, and the maestro would like for you to sing.
Oh. It's not that bad, I'm not that sad. The bee's coming home tomorrow.
Oh! Tomorrow, Snuffy will be home tomorrow.
Tomorrow, Snuffy will be home tomorrow.
Tomorrow, he'll be home.
He'll be home tomorrow.
Yes, Snuffy will be home tomorrow, 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 tomorrow. But now, it is so sad here. There is no glad here. Alas and alack, dear Snuffy, hurry back.
Boy, these opera singers are real emotional, aren't they? I mean, he's a lot sadder than I am, and he hardly even knows Snuffy.
Wow! Hey, come here. You want to see this great plant I grew from like a tiny seed?
Yeah.
No, wait till you see this, man. It's incredible.
Oh, well, it looks funny.
Oh, well, maybe it's asleep.
Well, wake it up, man.
All right. Hey, plant, wake up.
No, I think you have to, like, get an alarm clock or something. Oh, you know what? I just remembered. My dog always wakes me up.
Well, all right. Hey, Rex, come on, boy. Come on in here. Hey, yeah, that's a good boy.
Hey, Rex, how's it going? Look, wake up the plan, okay?
You know, my mother says a shower always wakes her up.
Wow, man, I gotta remember that. Oh, how could I be so dumb? Plants need water, man.
I like to make up stories, but my favorite thing to write about is something that really happened to me. First, I draw the pictures. I like to use markers because their colors are really bright. Then I write the words underneath. Sometimes I ask my mom how to spell a word.
Mom, how do you spell ingredients?
I-N-G-R-E-D-I-E-N-T-S.
You can staple the pages together or something simple like that, but I like to make a hard cover.
I use cardboard and I glue fabric over it. Then I sew the pages in. When the book is done, it looks really nice. It was my mother's birthday. My dad took my mom out for the day to a museum. My brother and I wanted to make my mom's birthday very special.
Seeing a couple of those guys.
So we planned a surprise. We went out and shopped for presents. We ended up getting headphones for our tape recorder. And we got some flowers too. Then we went shopping for some ingredients for a cake. A long time to make. When we were done, the sink was filled with dishes. Then we cleaned up and wrapped the presents. We all had a nice time eating the cake and opening the presents. Everything turned out perfect.
Snacks on parade. The raisin. Life begins for the raisin as a grape hanging on a vine in bunches in sunny California. Grapes are so sweet and so delicious that some people wanted to save their grapes for later. People tried keeping their grapes on ice. Some people kept them on the radiator. But no matter what, it was always the same. Icky poo. You just couldn't eat your grape later. It wasn't until the inventor of the raisin accidentally left a bunch of grapes in the sun while she did the wash, painted the house, and played the piano. Sometime later, she found her grapes were shriveled and brown from the sun. But so sweet and so tasty that she put more and more grapes out in the sun to dry. She put them in boxes, called them raisins, and gave them to friends. And the friends gave them to friends so they could eat them later. And they did.
Grover?
Yeah.
Grover?
Yeah?
What's the matter?
Well, I'm kind of shy.
You're shy with me?
Well, I know you, but I don't do well.
Oh, don't be shy. You know something? When you're shy, you never give people a chance to find out that they like you, that they want to tell you so. Yeah. I've got a little system I use sometimes. Mind coming closer to me?
Okay, should I sit on your lap?
Get in my lap here.
Okay.
I've got a little system I use when I'm feeling shy. And you know what I do?
Mm-hmm.
I say, how do you do? Hold out your hand.
Yeah.
Smile and say, glad to meet you.
I don't know.
Hope you are well. Happy you're here. Thoughts I feel when I greet you. People know you by the little things you do.
Yeah.
Show someone you care. Watch them care for you. Say, how do you do? Right from the heart. For the very first time, so very nice.
I think I understand.
Really?
I'll try it, okay?
Why don't you tell me what I said to you?
Okay, try. How do you do? Yeah. Hold out your hand.
That's right.
Smile and say, glad to meet you.
Yes, that's wonderful. Go ahead.
Hope you are well.
Very well.
Happy you're here.
Oh, thank you, Grover.
Thoughts I think when I greet you.
Yeah. Now listen, people know you by the little things you do. Show someone you care.
Then what?
Watch them care for you.
That sounds nice.
How do you do? Yes, right from the heart, hand in hand for the very first time. So very nice to meet a brand new friend of mine. See, that's all there is to it.
You know what?
What?
I am not shy anymore.
I'm so glad, girl.
Oh, great. Thank you.
R. R.
In the third act of our opera, Placido Flamingo visits the can of Oscar the Grouch and gets him to cooperate. Let's watch.
Wait, who said that? Hey, I don't cooperate with anybody, you hear me? So they think they can get me to cooperate, do they? Well, there's no way that I'm going to help out with this rotten opera. I'm not going to sing a note. I'm not going to say a word. I'm just going to sit here. Uh-oh, here they come now.
Olivia!
Yes, Placido.
Did you hear the one about the Grouch who cooperated?
No, tell me the one about the Grouch who cooperated.
He will not sing. He will not say a word. He will only sit there looking grouchy. And that is exactly what I want a Grouch to do in my opera.
In other words, he's cooperating.
Precisely.
What? Well, cooperate this. And I'm not coming out until tomorrow.
Tomorrow he won't come out until tomorrow.
Tomorrow he won't come out until tomorrow.
Tomorrow he'll come out.
He'll come out tomorrow.
He won't come out until tomorrow. 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 That's an aria, Olivia.
Oh, forgive me, maestro. Oh, forgive me.
It's all quite all right.
Rhinoceros. There once was a crazy rhinoceros who wished she could fly like an albatross. She climbed up a tree and said,
"Now, watch me!"
Then fell into a barrel of applesauce. Rhinoceros.
And now Sesame Street proudly presents Caveman Days, the show that lets you see how things were way back when. Today's episode, Taking the Kid to School. Yes, even way back when, in caveman days, each morning, the typical caveman father... would take his typical caveman baby son to nursery school. Yes, each morning the caveman father would say to his caveman baby son,
Ooga Mooga Mooga!
Which meant,
Okay, my caveman baby son, it's time for us to take a walk and drop you off at school.
To which the baby son would reply,
Mooga Ooga Ooga!
Which meant,
Right on, Dad.
And so the caveman father and his baby son would walk to the corner of the caveman street, where the baby son would then say,
Egga, mega, mega!
Which meant,
Is it okay to cross the street now, Dad?
And the father would reply,
Wiggy, Miggy, Muggle!
Which meant,
Well, look at that sign over there, my caveman baby son. See, that sign says, Don't walk. So we'd better not try to cross the street right now.
And then the baby son would say,
Agga, wagga, wagga, magga, hugga!
Which meant,
Why not?
And the caveman father would reply,
Oogie Moogle Moogle!
Which meant,
Well, there are many reasons, my caveman son. One of them, you see, there might be a very large dinosaur coming walking down the street towards us, and we don't want to get in his way. And matter of fact, look out! Ooh, that was a big one. That's just one reason that when that sign says, Don't walk, we must be sure not to walk. And you know, the sign also says, Don't walk, because somebody might be driving to work and we wouldn't want to cross the street against traffic.
And at this moment, each morning, the caveman baby son would look at his father and say,
Mega, 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 mega!
Which meant,
But Dad, we're cavemen. Cars haven't been invented yet. Cars won't be invented for millions of years.
To which the caveman father would reply,
Ooga booga boo!
Which meant,
Never mind.
And at just that moment, the don't walk sign would change. And instead of don't walk, the sign would now say walk. And the caveman father would hold his baby's hand and cross on their way to work and school. Be sure to tune in next time for another episode of Caveman Day.
Evening. Alistair Cookie here. Welcome to Monsterpiece Theater. Tonight, exciting tale of adventure from mysterious land of Arabian Nights. Ali Baba and 40 Thieves, starring Ricardo Montalban as Ali Baba. That Ali Baba. Okay, our story begins.
Hold it!
What?
Howdy,
about me.
Well, who are you?
One of the thieves. There's 40 of us, and we want to be introduced too.
Ridiculoso. I am the only one who should be introduced. I am playing Alibaba, and that is the title role.
Oh, yeah? Well, this place called Alibaba and the 40 Thieves. Yeah, our names are in the title, too.
Yes, your numbers, not your names. Yes, now just get back to your places so we can start my story.
It's not your story, it's our story. Yeah. And it does not get started till we get introduced.
Yes, we have all the nerve.
Hold on. Okay, now, we got show to do here, fellas, all right? Here we go. Alibaba and 40 Thieves, starring Ricardo Montalban as Alibaba. And introducing...
For the first time anywhere...
The 40 Thieves. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10, thank you for your patience. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, weird, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, no can stand attention. 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, coming to the end. 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, take me home, Professor, 36, 37, 38, 39, and 40.
Wonderful, wonderful. There, they've all been introduced. They all feel very special.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Now can we begin?
No.
No?
No.
But
introductions take so long, we out of time.
Oh, but we
know. And so,
it's all your fault.
This Alistair Cookie inviting you to tune in next time when Monster Peace Theater present Snow White and Seven Dwarfs. We think we can get that one in.
Though old and quite fat, he was still a curious cat, and his curiosity grew and grew. Every morning at 8, he could hear the front gate. All were gone. It was time to explore. He'd climb into drawers and with delicate paws investigate this thing and that. He delighted in strings, pearl necklaces, rings, this incurably curious cat. In the kitchen there was more for the curious to explore, like cupboards full of bottles and cans. What's in here, I wonder? But then came the blunder. He leaned back, then it rained pots and pans.
In the fourth act of our opera, Placido Flamingo visits his honker friends and sings a song with a quartet of honkers. Let's watch.
And now, eh? What is this? There are only 3 honkers here. I am supposed to sing with a quartet of honkers, and a quartet means 4.
Well, maybe the other honker couldn't make it. Can't you just sing with the 3 of them?
No. 3 would be a trio. This is the 4th act of the opera, so I must sing with 4.
Why don't we just forget about the honkers and you and me? We'll sing together.
No. 2 would be a duet. And I must sing with a quartet. And a quartet is 4. Wait a minute. I know. Yes. You, Olivia. You will play a 4th honker.
Me? You, me?
Mm-hmm.
Nope.
Yes, Olivia. You must. We are all counting on you. Please play the 4th honker so that the opera can go on.
All right.
Thank you. Please forgive this little delay. The opera will continue in just a moment. Hurry, Olivia, we are waiting.
I'm coming.
Perfect. 1, 2, 3 honkers plus 1 more honker makes 4 honkers. And that makes a quartet. Let the opera continue.
A duet. If you have 3, or you have a trio, when we sing together, it is fun, much more fun than with 1. And so I'll sing with 4. I'll sing with 4. Now that I have 1 more, everybody, 4 is a quartet. 2 is a duet. If you have 3, oh. Have a trio. When we sing together, it is fun, much more fun than with 1. And so we'll sing with 4, we'll sing with 4, now that we have 1 more.
Thank you. Gracias. Gracias.
If I could only paddle like a doggy on a paddle, I would paddle my way to you. No river too wide or lake too deep. I'd splash on forward any dick to keep. If I could only paddle like a doggy on a paddle, I could paddle the ocean blue. And nothing out of place, a doggy steady paddle pace, I could paddle my way to, gotta get through to, paddle my way to you.
Bottles!
The Great Dadini will begin by balancing two bottles. One plus one is two bottles, ladies and gentlemen. The Great Dadini is now balancing two bottles. She will add two more bottles, which will make four bottles. Two plus one is three. Three plus one is four bottles, ladies and gentlemen, four. The Great Dadini is now balancing four bottles. She will add two more bottles, which will make six bottles. Four plus one is five bottles. Five plus one is six bottles, ladies and gentlemen.
Roses are red. Oh. Ah. Violets are blue. Sugar is sweet. Oh, and so are you.
There's one or two or ten or three. Don't want to complain or raise a fuss, but them birds up there think I'm a motor bus. Oh, gee, there's a bird on me. Oh, don't you see? There's a bird on me. They sit there talking to each other, not to me. Now, how do I find a way to explain that I'm not a boat or a railway train? Little birdie, fly away. Don't you come back no other day. Shoo. Well, can't you see? There's a bird on me. Oh, woe is me, there's a bird on me. I'm so darn sick of every feathered friend, oh gee. Stop your chirping and quack, quack, quack. Come on, bird, get off of my back.
The letter Z. Zigzag. Zero. Zoo. Zebra. The letter Z. Goodbye.
And now, as we come to the last act of our opera, Placido Flamingo.
Wait, hold on. So, Placido. He said this was the last act. I haven't done my solo yet. You promised me a solo. You said that I was going to get the singer solo all by myself.
Yes,
you know,
I
was going to come out those doors,
yes,
down the stairs in a beautiful costume,
yes,
and the orchestra was going to play and everybody's going to listen.
Well,
where is it?
Don't worry, my dear. You shall. If you go up the stairs behind the door, you will find your beautiful costume waiting for you. So please change quickly because it is time for your solo.
Oh, okay.
Please forgive us again. These sopranos can be so temperamental. As soon as she gets into her beautiful costume, she will be back to sing for you. And are you ready, Olivia?
Yes, I'm ready. Do you call this a beautiful costume?
Why, certainly I do. What could be more beautiful than pink flamingo feathers like mine? Sing, Olivia, sing. This is your big moment.
But what? Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters R and Z and the number 4. Sesame Street is a production of Children's Television Workshop. So long. We'll see you tomorrow.
Oh! Tomorrow we will be coming back. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow we will be coming back. Tomorrow.
Tomorrow we'll be back.
We'll be back tomorrow.
We will be coming back.
The Metropolitan Opera has been proud to present La Via Sesamia, an opera written by Placido Flamingo, directed by Placido Flamingo, and starring the great Placido Flamingo, also starring Olivia. This is your announcer saying so long until tomorrow.